तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान ने लाहौर हाई कोर्ट का फैसला मुअत्तल कर दिया है। सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने लाहौर हाई कोर्ट को कार्रवाई से रोक दिया है। अहम तरीन खबर, अहम तरीन समात इस वक्त भी जारी है। चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ पाकिस्तान काजी फाइज ईसा इस वक्त हुक्मनामा तहरीर करवा रहे हैं।
इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ पाकिस्तान Wherein the two petitioners before us and eight others were arrayed as respondents. All the petition sought the raid for it sought a declaration the sections 50 within bracket 1 bracket close within bracket small b and 51 within bracket 1 within bracket bracket closed from 2017 was unconstitutional, comma, void, comma, without lawful authority and of no legal effect. The two provisions which had been assailed are reproduced here under. The petition further prayed. The said provisions section 50 pertains to the appointment of district returning officers by the election commission of Pakistan bracket mein karte hain ECP and section 51 of the appointment of returning officers and assistant returning officers full stop the petition stated that instead it is submitted by Mr. Sajil Shehriyar Sawati, Learned Kazi, representing, representing the petitioners, that the stated two provisions of law have been part of the Elections Act and subsisted at the time when the last elections were held and till date no one has taken any exception thereto full stop it is further submitted that this court right video italics mein kar dijiyega its order where was that order gone
224 page huh? third of November
the page
224 224 third of November
right judgment dated 3 November 2023 tending to a number of constitution petitions filed in the this court wherein the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf within bracket PTI was also one of the petitioners oblique appellants had sought the had sought that a date for holding of elections we announced full stop. Pursuant to the notice being taken by this court, the President of Pakistan and the ECP met and decided that general elections should be held on 8 February 2024. Full stop. The federal government, the provincial governments, and Islamabad capital territory, all of whom were represented before us, concurred. This court held that, no one should now put forward any pretext to derail democracy, paragraph 18 of the said judgment, The Learned Council submits that to enable elections to be held, to ensure elections are held on 8th of February, the certain number of days are required to do the different acts which the law requires prior to the holding of the said elections. And the passing of the impugned order at the 11th hour, if it remains in the field, would make the holding of elections on 8th February, would not permit the holding of elections on 8th February 2024. Full stop. It is further stated that the ECP had drafted the schedule for elections. What do you call it?
Program.
What is it?
Which section?
57. Drafted the election program, capital E, capital P, which it was intending to announce today. But the passing of the impugn order has created, passing of the impugned order, that if the impugned order is sustained, this will not be possible, as without having district returning officers, returning officers and assistant returning officers, election cannot be held. First of all, he further states that the learned judge acted in undue, that the learned judge has effectively decided the petition. That there is an inherent contradiction in the impugned order. Because where is impugned order page?
Page 10, my lord.
Because in paragraph 7, he states that this file states, to place this file before the Honorable HON'BLE, Chief Justice for the Constitution of a larger bench, capital L, capital B, And at the same time, in the successive paragraph 8, he suspends four notifications issued by the ECP, particulars whereof are as under. ये numbers ले लीजिएगा, उसके लिख दीजिएगा.
My lord. Actually.
Please sit down. Who are you? You are dictating an order. Please sit down. Seems to be no respect for anybody anymore. Next time you do it, we'll hold you in contempt. Who are you, a lawyer? Where have you studied? Please go and sit at the back. I don't know what's happening, what sort of education is being imparted. Supreme Court is dictating an order and she comes and stands up. Is she with you?
She is not an advocate of this court, shouldn't have addressed the court.
I don't know.
Yeah. Is she with you?
No. We don't know.
Which respectively appointed 8 returning officers for the seats reserved for women and non-Muslims, 144 district returning officers for elections to the National Assembly and Provincial Assemblies, 266 returning officers and assistant returning officers. Ye bhi National Assembly and Provincial Assembly for elections to the National and Provincial Assemblies, and 593. Ye kya cheez hai? 216 national karte hain, 593
provincial
returning officer and assistant for provincial assemblies, for elections to the provincial assemblies. As such, altogether 1,011 district returning officers and returning officers their working has been stopped with the stroke of a pen by the learned single judge. The learned single judge also did not fail to appreciate that the officers that had been appointed were to perform functions throughout Pakistan, and in passing the impugned order, the learned judge acted well beyond the territorial jurisdiction of the High Court. Let's talk. As if this was not enough, the very opening words of Article 199 were disregarded by the learned judge, insofar as it stipulates that when there's an alternate adequate remedy available to the petitioner, the same should be availed of first. We are informed that Section 55,
subsection 3,
was such a remedy. If the petitioner had a grievance against any particular returning officer or officers, may we inquired from the petitioners whether any application was submitted before the ECP under Section 55(3). That is availing of the alternate adequate remedy, and we were told that this was not done. The petitioner states that he is an office holder of the very same political party, that is PTI, which was before this court when the said judgment was passed, wherein no such concern as expressed in the petition filed before the High Court was stated. Full stop. The petitioner being, the petitioner also claims to be a barrister, and as such is expected not only to know, be well conversant with the constitution and the laws of Pakistan, but to have read the judgment of this court, which had clearly stipulated that any attempt to derail democracy would, what is the line exactly? Where was our judgment? 224?
Lord, it's at page 231, paragraph 18 at page 231. The last line of paragraph 18 at page 231.
That, that no one would, that, no one, that no one should be allowed to, on any pretext, to derail democracy. Full stop. One individual. As, however, one individual appears to have just done just that. And it is indeed a matter of considerable regret that he claims to belong to a political party. And has served in such political party. And we are told that he served as an additional advocate general when the said political party was in government. Full stop. We, in view of the conduct of the petitioner, we call upon him to submit an explanation why action for contempt of court should not be initiated against him for judicial contempt.
My lord, it should be, it would be, yes, civil contempt, my lord, this disregarding of the court order under section
for contempt of court ordinance, 2003, read with article 204 of the constitution. The learned judge, acting in undue haste and at the 11th hour, the learned counsel went through the list of returning officers appointed pursuant to the four notifications and stated that they were all, that in one of these notifications pertains to the officers of the ECP, whereas the remaining three are all serving government servants who already were holding their respective positions and have not been put in place for the purpose of this election or on anyone's behest. The petitioner before the High Court also, a learned counsel further states that the that initially the ECP had written, had pursuant to section 51, and pursuant to
50 subsection 1 clause C and 51(1)
and 51 within bracket 1, written to the chief justices of the five high courts and requested them to provide judicial officers for the upcoming elections, and not a single one of the chief justices agreed to do so. He has referred to a letter issued by the Lahore High Court, which specifically stated that. What letter is page
211. 6th of February.
Then you have your reply.
210. Reply. 210 to 211.
Emphatic reply was given that no judicial officers can be spared because there are over 1.3 million cases requiring adjudication. About 1.3 million cases requiring adjudication and delaying and provision of such officers would result in tendency to increase and of which the ultimate sufferers would be the litigants. Full stop. Under such circumstances, for the petitioner to insist on judicial officers to be provided would effectively mean that a writ be issued against the High Court, which is not permissible under Article 199.
Clause 5. But this is the Chief Justice.
And in this regard, he places his reliance upon the case of Gultaz Khan Marwat.
Gultaz Khan.
Yeah, you
have to come to the Supreme Court.
And versus Registrar Peshawar High Court, PLD 2021, Supreme Court 391, which was a judgment by a far member bench of this court.
इसमें हमने क्या किया
इसमें कहा कि रेगुलेटर टीम है कि हाईकोर्ट के अगेंस्ट
हाँ
एंड बिकम द वंडरफुल
The only remedy in such a case, according to this judgment, is to approach this court.
And it was held therein that if at all there was any remedy, it would be to approach the Supreme Court of Pakistan, which judgment appears to have also been disregarded, both by the petitioner as well as the learned judge, the learned single judge. Full stop. Under the circumstances, it would be appropriate to that we hereby direct that the
what's the number of petition?
The High Court petition.
It's that writ petition number 80828/2023 be called from the that the High Court should not take any further proceedings in WP number 80828/2023 and the same be placed before the and the same be sent to the Supreme Court, and if it is deemed necessary, this court will fix it for hearing. What is court? Who's talk? The in view of the fact ordinarily this court does not pass, it does not suspend orders without issuing of notice, but in view of the fact, but in view of the extra, but in view of the fact that the impugned order has come into direct conflict with the judgment of this court, and as the petition as filed appears not to be maintainable, we are doing so. Full stop. Impugned order also comes in the way of the Election Commission to proceed with its duties and responsibilities, constitutional duties and responsibilities for the holding of elections as mandated under the Constitution.
What can we refer?
The without further delay, order of suspend kar diya na, kar diya,
dekha
hai, accordingly impugned in the given circumstances and considering the constitutional stipulations, constitutional and legal stipulations, and the judgment of this court, judgments of this court, impugned order is thereby suspended and full stop. The Election Commission shall
तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान ने लाहौर हाई कोर्ट का फैसला मुअत्तल कर दिया है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने लाहौर हाई कोर्ट को कार्रवाई से रोक दिया है. अहम तरीन खबर, अहम तरीन समात इस वक्त भी जारी है. चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ पाकिस्तान काजी फाइज ईसा इस वक्त हुक्मनामा तहरीर करवा रहे हैं.
इशू टुडे टुनाइट क्या
टुडे
प्लीज अभी तीन घंटे
एस बी प्लीज और एज द लॉ मैंडेट्स
यू शुड बी सेइंग दैट आपने ही करना है ना.
ये नहीं करना तो बता दें.
वी आर ऑल वी आर रेडी सर एज पर योर डायरेक्शंस.
हम तो नहीं कहेंगे, हम आपसे अपना काम करवाएंगे. ये आपके हमें काम करना नहीं आता है जो आप कहें. हम कभी किसी को नहीं कहेंगे, उससे काम करवाएंगे उसका.
विदाउट फेल लिखेंगे, वी विल इशू द इलेक्शन प्रोग्राम विदाउट फेल.
द अंडरटेकिंग इज गिवन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द इलेक्शन कमीशन दैट द इलेक्शन प्रोग्राम विल बी इशूड टुडे. सुन लिया आपने?
और वो भी कि वो जो आपने इन व्यू ऑफ नोटिफिकेशन किया था उसको भी आज विड्रॉ कीजिए, वरना तो नहीं चल सकेगा ना.
वो विड्रॉ नोटिफिकेशन कहाँ है? वो नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ द इलेक्शन इशू, नोटिफिकेशन इशूड बाय द इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ पाकिस्तान पर्सुएंट टू द इम्प्यून्ड ऑर्डर ऑफ द हाई कोर्ट इज आल्सो सस्पेंडेड. वो आप करेंगे नहीं अभी रोड. इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ पाकिस्तान स्टेट्स दैट द सिंस द इम्प्यून्ड ऑर्डर हैज बीन सस्पेंडेड इट विल बी ऑटोमेटिक ईसीपी विल बी विड्रॉइंग द क्या नाम है इसका नोटिफिकेशन डेटेड
14/12/2023
का कोई नंबर भी है?
नंबर बता दे.
नंबर स्टेशन नंबर F2 ऑफ ये पेज 234 पे लगा
35 अच्छा तो हां 34
34 and 35 ڈیٹ بھی لکھ دیجیے گا
نیکسٹ پیج پہ بھی ہے
ناؤ
235 پہ بھی ہے دونوں سیم ڈیٹ ایون ڈیٹ
تو اس میں نوٹس کس کو کریں ہم respondent number 1 herein
My lord, we will resume the training on Monday onwards. This is what the learned secretary is saying. Because
you have tomorrow. Why are you missing out tomorrow?
May I just submit?
No, please don't. Just do the law. Abide by the law. Hold
sir,
election.
Sir, may I just submit if you allow me, sir? So there's it's a huge logistical exercise. All the DROs, ROs will have to be brought to the venues. The venues have been cancelled. We have to, you know, just the delay of.
नहीं नहीं हमें हमें देखें.
Monday का सिर्फ हम शुरू.
हम कुछ नहीं लिखेंगे.
Sir.
हम ना कल का लिखेंगे ना Monday का लिखेंगे. आपका जो काम है आप करो आप देखिए हम आपको माइक्रो मैनेज नहीं करेंगे
थैंक यू
हम मोटी मोटी बात करेंगे आपने कहा जी हम इलेक्शन करना चाहते हैं 8 को
जी इंशाल्लाह
हमने तो नहीं कहा आपने कहा है ना आप और सदर साहब ने मिलकर के तयन कर लिया कि 8 फरवरी को करना है हमने कहा आपको इलेक्शन 8 को करें हमने आपको कहा क्या ठीक है जब आपने ये काम कर लिया जो भी चीजें वहां तक जाने के लिए करने को हैं वो आप करें कल को आप कहेंगे जी सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने ये कर दिया सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने वो कर दिया और हम ये नहीं कर सके तो वो नहीं कर सके भाई जो कुछ करना है करें अब आपके सामने एक मसला था रुकावट थी वो रुकावट और वो मसला हमने दूर कर दिया अब आप अपना काम कीजिए हम लोग अपना काम करेंगे और अगर इजाजत दें तो मैं फिर छुट्टी पे जा सकता हूं
माय लॉर्ड जस्ट
हैव अ ग्रेट वेकेशन सर
आई जस्ट डिटेनिंग यू फॉर 30 सेकंड्स नोटिस मे आल्सो बी इशू टू द फेडरेशन
ओह यस यस सर नो अ नोटिस बी आल्सो इशू टू द फेडरेशन ऑफ टू रिस्पोंडेंट नंबर
5 माय लॉर्ड
5 एज वेल एज नोटिस अंडर आर Order 27A of the Code of Civil Procedure 1908 to the Attorney General, Advocate General ko bhi karne and the Advocate Generals of the 4 provinces. Islamabad ka kaun hota hai?
वो भी होते हैं बट
एडवोकेट जनरल कहते हैं
फेडरल लॉ है तो वो
एंड इस्लामाबाद कैपिटल टेरिटरी चल एनीथिंग एल्स जेंटलमैन
आई लिव लाइक Apologies once again for
No, it's not your doing. You are before us, but we must at least I must compliment you for being so thorough in a very short period of time, and which is always a pleasure to have counsel who are ready with their case, particularly at such. छोड़ो सी में भी ऑर्डर पर करिएगा ठीक है हाँ हाँ वो वाली ग्रांट कर दें वो एग्जेम्पशन वाली ठीक
है ऑल्सो माय लॉर्ड मे ऑल्सो विश टू ग्रांट द लीव एंड देन Grant, leave may also be granted because it's a CPLA, so a leave has to be granted.
Okay. The points, Kulikdina, points, now you can see I'm very tired. the points raised above, in kya hota hai?
leave is granted to consider, amongst others, the noted points.
Thank you.
इस प्रोविजन में कौन सी चीज है जो फेयर इलेक्शंस के रास्ते में आती है?
They are saying कि the appointment from executive will hamper the fairness of the election.
वो प्रोविजन unconstitutional declare कर रहे हैं. All times to come.
Yes. This is what they have challenged it on.
For all times to come.
जरा प्रेयर
ये जुडिशरी से होना चाहिए. Let me take your lordship to the prayer.
प्रेयर पढ़िए जरा. उसमें क्लियर हो जाएगा.
My lord.
जरा पढ़े. मुकम्मल कह रहे हैं कि उनको खत्म किया जाए.
वो कह रहे हैं कि सेक्शन 51 इज अल्ट्रावायलेट.
प्लीज बेयर विद अस, एज यूजुअली वी रीड पिटीशंस बिफोर वी कम टू कॉल.
जी माय लॉर्ड,
दिस इज अ टाइम व्हेन वी हैव नॉट रेड इट
बिकॉज़ आई अंडरस्टैंड.
जी,
इट्स एट पेज 25 माय लॉर्ड.
जी,
एंड द प्रेयर स्टार्ट्स एट द बॉटम.
जी,
इन व्यू ऑफ द ग्राउंड्स एंड फैक्ट्स एक्सप्लिकेटेड, it is most respectfully prayed that the instant petition may kindly be allowed and impugned sections 51b and 51(1) of elections act 2017 may kindly be declared unconstitutional, void, without lawful authority and of no legal effect. Alternatively, it is prayed that section 51b of the election act, to the extent of the expression list of officers provided by the government or a provincial government therein, may kindly be declared unconstitutional, void, without lawful authority and of no legal effect. Further, the election commission may kindly be directed to initiate consultation process with the honorable chief justice of the high courts for the appointment of judicial officers as DROs and returning officers under section 50 and 51 of the elections act for the general elections. Moreover, it may kindly be declared that in general elections cannot be conducted in fair, transparent, free and impartial, independent manner in presence of DROs and ROs from the executive branch of the state.
ये तो कभी भी challenge कर सकते थे पहले भी.
It has been there for the 6 years.
जब ROs appoint हो गए तो उनको ये सब याद है.
We are at the verge of issuing the.
ये एक second, ये law कब बना है?
2017 my lord.
Last
6 years.
Law elections कब हुए?
2018.
On the basis of
this section 50 and 51.
Last election में जो DRO थे वो
जुडिशियल ऑफिसर्स थे. दिस वाज द फर्स्ट टाइम.
नहीं, जुडिशियल ऑफिसर तो नहीं थे.
जुडिशियल ऑफिसर्स थे. जो DROs है, डिस्ट्रिक्ट रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर्स है, वो तो डिस्ट्रिक्ट जुडिशियल ऑफिसर्स से.
रिटर्निंग
ऑफिसर्स भी जुडिशियल उससे लिए थे. ARO जो है, इट वाज अ मिक्स फॉर्म.
बट ये आप हम पे जबरदस्ती तो नहीं कर सकते हैं. इसमें लिखा है फ्रॉम द जुडिशरी सबॉर्डिनेट जुडिशरी इन कंसल्टेशन विद द चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ द कंसर्न्ड हाई कोर्ट. So how can somebody impose it? Suppose even you write to the Chief Justice, then it's his discretion whether he wants to spare a judicial officer or officers or not.
Yes. In fact, what we did was, we did write to all the five honorable Chief Justices of the High Court.
When?
Different letters.
Are they on and record?
Ji, they are on the record.
Are they kind?
कब लिखा
है? द फर्स्ट वन इज द लाहौर हाई कोर्ट. इट्स एट पेज 208. लेटर वाज डेटेड 1st of February 2023 इन फरवरी माय लॉर्ड. एंड देयर वाज अ क्लियर रिग्रेट.
वेयर इज
द रिग्रेट?
इट्स एट पेज 208. देयर आर टू लेटर्स ऑफ लाहौर हाई कोर्ट. द रिप्लाई इज एट पेज 210 ऑफ द पेपर.
अच्छा, यू रोट एज फार बैक एज 1st of February?
यस माय लॉर्ड, बिकॉज़ द प्रोविंशियल असेंबली ऑफ द पंजाब वाज.
फिर बताएं, फिर कब?
फिर माय लॉर्ड, 210 पे. 210 पे, पेज 210 पे लेटर ऑफ रिग्रेट है.
पढ़ दें?
जी माय लॉर्ड, मैं टेक योर लॉर्डशिप टू 211 पे.
नहीं, रिग्रेट में जो रीजंस दिए हैं एज वी स्पीक.
जी, देयर वाज अ शॉर्टेज ऑफ जुडिशियल स्टाफ एंड ऑल दैट.
पढ़ लेना.
इट्स पैरा टू.
Para 1.
Ji.
Para 2, 1.
Para 2, 1. As we speak, a huge number of cases totaling 13,12,480 are pending adjudication in the courts of district and session judge, additional district and sessions judges, senior civil judges and civil judges throughout Punjab. And if services of majority of these officers are given as district returning officers and returning officers at the disposal of Election Commission of Pakistan, this pendency would mount to by many fold. And the ultimate sufferers will be the poor litigants, resultantly hampering the entire scheme and system of district dispensation of justice at the grassroots level, and this cannot be afforded compromise at the cost of delay in justice and aggravating nuisance of the human right.
But if this letter is already in the field, then the petitioner does not want elections. If the Chief Justice, the Lahore High Court, the others have also declined or not?
Out of five, the Islamabad High Court did not respond.
Jee.
We wrote in September and October to all the others. The Peshawar High Court said ke, go to Destitute Judicial Policy. Aap wahan se jaake clarification to accede to our request. And Balochistan High Court initially agreed, but later on the learned registrar said ke, no, we cannot provide. This was as near as the 2 weeks back. And Sindh High Court, just like Lahore High Court ka ek aur superseding letter hai, wo main abhi padhta hu, they said ke, jab aap election program issue karenge, phir hume request bhejiyega. To election program to bilkul at the verge aata hai, humne ARO's aur DRO's ki training to pehle karni hai.
Wo to pehle hoti hai. Achha. Nahi to phir iska matlab hai ke your first choice was
judicial officer.
But the High Courts did not agree.
Did not agree.
And for valid reasons, because you know you whole election and you, the litigant then suffers.
And judges, that 1.5 months.
There is also another aspect, because you know, I remember the elections when we did give judicial officers, and this was, I think, when I was Chief Justice of Balochistan, then the allegations invariably, and you know, we also do judicial work, then the same matter may come before us in a judicial forum. Because election tribunals are also judicial officers. So it could be argued that, you know, this is a job, if we have a clearly separation of powers of the executive, the judiciary, the legislature, we forget one important pillar, which is the election commission. But that I don't, it's not a part of the executive, it's not a part of the judiciary, it's on its own.
We are a federal institution, but a constitutional body on its own, not under any.
Yes. So your choice was not, the first choice was not, you didn't appoint yourself.
No, my lord.
You asked the judiciary.
We were constrained.
And the judiciary, basically, this in Punjab, there is a clear cut no.
Clear cut no. Uske baad, in October,
then
there was another letter.
Then I'm just thinking, how can the learned judge suspend an order? He will issue a writ against the High Court.
That's one of our grounds.
No, then the learned single judge has passed an order.
The single learned single judge.
What, the Chief Justice to provide officers? I mean, can a writ be issued against the High Court? So what sort of relief do they want, or they don't want elections? Where is this Mr. Niazi? I mean, if one person is going to hold Pakistan to ransom, I mean, he's just one individual. And he says, I'm so and so.
No political party has come forward to challenge this
political parties in a business of elections. So why would they want an election. And this one political party says, I don't want elections. But it was the very same political party whose petition I decided.
Yes, we have attached that 3rd of November's order along with this petition.
But usme to the election, why didn't they say those things then? It was represented before us, if I remember correctly, by...
Please, of course.
Yes,
Mr. Ali Zafar was representing Pakistan.
There was no such demand or suggestion, and we kind of got the order. This appears to be, I don't know if it's a bona fide petition or not.
My lord, in fact, with due respect to the learned single judge, there's not even a single ground which provision is ultra vires.
Where is your
order? My lord, the order starts at page 10.
Let's read the operative part.
Page 12, my lord.
Page 12?
At page 12, para 4.
No, you're legally under challenge.
These are the discussions.
Can you read paragraph 7?
My lord, then we go to the speaking part, which is para 7 and 8.
Nee, 7 padhe.
Jee, 7. Keeping in view the importance of the legal interpretation of the constitutional provision having legal effect deeply connected to the national issue.
Where is the constitution provision? There's no constitution.
There's no. The whole order is silent as to it.
I don't know. Let's read it further.
Having legal effect deeply connected to the raised national issue, office is directed to place this file before the Honorable Chief Justice for constitution of a larger bench. page.
But he has not passed in an order.
My lord, these are the reasons. Para 5, 6, and
8. Pe kya kehte?
8 is the suspension order. Notice, meanwhile, the notification dated sare ke sare 11 December 2023, issued by the Election Commission of Pakistan, appointing the DROs, ROs, assistant returning officers from executive shall remain suspended.
Shall
remain suspended. So there is a complete
once again, I fail to understand. If a judge is passing an order for constitution of a larger bench, then judicial propriety demands that he stays his hand.
Yes.
Now how can then he pass an order? Either he passes an order and doesn't say the matter be placed before the Chief Justice, then the Chief Justice has been given a fait accompli. You do what I ask you to do.
In fact,
so either you request the Chief Justice of the Constitutional Larger Bench, or you don't make this request and you just proceed with the matter.
Yes, my lord.
So, has the Larger Bench been constituted?
It has been constituted for Monday.
Who is heading the Larger Bench?
The very honorable judge.
The same judge?
The same judge.
Two other judges.
Five member bench.
This is very strange. So what is the purpose of this petition?
In fact,
let's look at logically.
My lord.
Now, who have you appointed? Have you appointed people of some political party as ROs or DROs?
No, my lord.
Who have you appointed?
These are a mix.
Show us.
My lord.
There are four notifications.
Ji.
Let's take the first one.
Notifications are at page 27.
One at a time, Karin.
My lord. It starts at page 27, my lord. Page. The notification.
This is for DROs.
These are DROs.
11th of
December. Notifications all across the country have been suspended.
It's all across the country.
In Sindh and Balochistan also.
My lord, this notification is across the country. This
how many DROs in the country? Kitne DROs appoint hue?
Per district, every district.
Kitne hai, total kitne hai sare?
85. No.
Achha, ye pehla wala dekhe. Achha, I am told it's 144.
ये
जरा कैलकुलेट कर लें डी आर ओज और ए आर ओज टोटल कितने ऑल पाकिस्तान
टोटल 148
ए आर ओ डी आर ओज ऑल ओवर पाकिस्तान कितना है टोटल फिगर
ए आर ओज इज 148
और ROs कितने हैं? AROs हैं।
चलिए आप इनको हिसाब लगा के देखें ऐसी बातें ना करें कागज के
टुकड़े कर दे ना हमें टोटल फिगर
गिन के बताइए
859
ROs। अच्छा नहीं हम जरा इनके नाम देखना चाहते हैं किसको आपने अपॉइंट किया है ये रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर पेज 27 पे कौन है ये लोग पेज 27 पे आपने पहला बताया ना ये
दिस इज द रिजर्व सीट वाला नोटिफिकेशन
तो देना कौन है DROs किसके ये रिश्तेदार
दीज आर फ्रॉम आवर ओन ऑफिसर्स
पढ़ देना डेजिग्नेशंस पढ़ दे नाम ना पढ़ें
मोहम्मद फरीद अफरीदी एडिशनल डायरेक्टर जनरल इलेक्शंस 1 इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ पाकिस्तान
ये तो चैलेंज भी नहीं हुआ और सस्पेंड हो गया
ये तो सारे आपके अपने
ये तो हमारे अपने
हैं हमने चैलेंज ही नहीं किया पिटीशनर
नहीं किया
उसने तो खाली कहा था कि सिर्फ जो एग्जीक्यूटिव
देयर वाज अ सीएम फाइल उसके अंदर ने कहा कि ये वाला भी इंक्लूड
करें इवन दो द वरीज इज ओनली चैलेंज
तो फिर आप भी इलेक्शन ना कराएं एग्जीक्यूटिव भी ना इलेक्शन करें जुडिशियल ऑफिसर भी ना इलेक्शन कराएं तो एक्चुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव इज नॉट टू होल्ड इलेक्शंस देन
दैट इज प्राइम ऑफ शायद
स्वाति द वरीज ऑफ सेक्शन 51D हैज बीन चैलेंज दिस इज अंडर ए
Yes.
ये तो चैलेंज ही नहीं हुआ ना
और these all have been suspended.
ये तो आपके अपने दफ्तर के मतलब अपने इलेक्शन कमीशन के लोग हैं
जी दिस नोटिफिकेशन जो कि रिजर्व सीट फॉर वुमेन के लिए है वो हमारे ऑफिस
अगला वाला पढ़े
नेक्स्ट इज पेज 29 पे
अब ये कौन है DROs
ये DROs है जी मोहम्मद इरफानुद्दीन
नाम नहीं बताएं डेजिग्नेशन बताएं
डिप्टी कमिश्नर अपर चतराल
तो ये तो सारे डिप्टी कमिश्नर्स हैं
जी सारे डिप्टी कमिश्नर
तो ये इसमें तो आपने हम देखना चाह रहे हैं कि आपने कोई पिक एंड चूज की है
नो
ये तो आपने
वी इन फैक्ट
एक सेकंड ये सारे इस पेज पे डिप्टी कमिश्नर्स हैं दूसरे तीसरे चौथे पांचवे छठे ये तो सारे डिप्टी कमिश्नर्स
ऑल आर डिप्टी कमिश्नर्स
The DROs are deputy commissioners.
They are the deputy.
तो इसमें आपने कोई मतलब ये नहीं कि एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट से एक को लगा दिया हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंट से दूसरे को लगा दिया
DROs are all deputy commissioners of the relevant districts.
माशाल्लाह तो अब तीसरा नोटिफिकेशन कहाँ है
तीसरा नोटिफिकेशन है जी पेज 39 पे जी
39
पे माल ऑर्डर इट्स 11 दिसंबर एडिशनल डिप्टी कमिश्नर जनरल
ये भी सारे आपके एडिशनल कमिश्नर
डिप्टी कमिश्नर विदाउट एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बल्कि व्हेन
नहीं तो आपने कोई पिक एंड चूज नहीं
किया नो
They were already posted.
In fact, jab hum the caretaker government came, we issued a directive ke shuffle all the appointees jo ke pichli wali governments ke the ya wo sare, and the all the deputy commissioners and the higher administrative machinery was shuffled, actually shuffled. So these are actually working.
When was that? When was the shuffling?
Ye different times pe hote hai, ye February se shuru hui hai shuffling karwane, kyunki province of Punjab the election had to take place at that time.
Who is the gentleman barrister Umair Khan Niazi?
He says he is the general secretary.
Has he attached any authority from the party itself?
No, there is none. He's just one individual person
has come and challenged the notifications of all Pakistan DROs.
Sabotage the whole process.
Is he related to because the word is Niazi, is he related?
I have no idea.
I don't know.
That's no concern, but the,
then you, and who have been President of Pakistan, Prime Minister, इनको भी पार्टी बनाया हुआ है।
जी, उनको भी पार्टी बनाया
हुआ है। उनका क्या काम इससे?
President, because the President had announced the date.
So basically, they don't want elections to take place. The President and the Election Commission together, if I remember, वो हमारा order किधर है जो हमने पास किया था?
That is at page 3rd of January 224, my lord.
हाँ?
224. Page 224.
Two.
Of the petition, my lord. And the speaking.
Isme the Pakistan Tehreek Insaf is one of the
petitioner.
Petitioner. So, isme to humne wazeh taur pe likha hua hai page paragraph
30 pe para 17
mein padhiye.
Ji malum. Para 17, your lordship.
Paragraph 17 ya 18.
Para 17. It starts at para 17 and
18. Padhiye. Wo to zara puri history de rahe.
18 is the President of Pakistan and the Election Commission have announced the date for holding of general elections to the National Assembly and the Provincial Assemblies. The federal government, the provincial governments and the Islamabad Capital Territory have concurred. The matter of holding the general election on 8th February stands resolved. No one should now put forward any pretext to derail democracy.
No, but shall we issue him contempt notice?
Exactly.
No, isn't this word clear? No one should now put forward any pretext to derail democracy.
The timing is very important.
Sorry, this is Barrister Umair Khan Niazi, then this is a violation of the Supreme Court order.
It's a violation of my...
And this petition is entertained and interim order passed, and then larger bench is constituted, which is again headed by the same judge.
The lordship. And so much so, there is a clear verdict, 12-member bench, ki provision of the law till it is actually declared. It's not a case. Ki aap usko operation nahi suspend kar sakte.
Law ko chhod dijiye, main pe chalte hai na.
Your lordship.
Ayin mein aap, ye kiska kaam election karwana?
Election commission.
Kaun sa provision hai?
218 and 19, my lord.
218
and 19.
And 19,
my lord. Mr. Swati, while we read this, ye zara bataye ki petitioner ne kya kaha ki ye takriban 1000 aadmi ban rahe hai na?
Ji.
Something like this.
Ji.
1014 bande.
1014 bande jo hain, isme se kya inke bare mein kya problem hai?
Ye keh rahe hain ji ki MPOs ke order bhi yehi DCs pass kar rahe hain. Wo to under the law unhone hi pass karne. Ye
sare ke sare hi matlab
chale aapko. Sare ke sare nahi hata de aur judicial officer.
Aapko ho sakta hai na ki ye meri constituency mein aapne ek khas banda laga diya hai.
One of hota to shayad we could have entertained that. Ki ye ek banda biased hai.
Yehi main sawal aapse puchne wala hu. इस पिटिशन से फाइल करने से पहले उन्हें आपको कोई दरखास्त दी बराए करम ये कर दीजिए
नो
स्ट्रेट अवे हाई कोर्ट
स्ट्रेट अवे हाई कोर्ट और अभी 5 दिन पहले
1014 जो भी लोग हैं ये सारे वो क्या कहते हैं पिटिशन में देयर बायस्ड
दे से के दे बिलोंग टू द मशीनरी ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव और एग्जीक्यूटिव के ऊपर हमारा ट्रस्ट नहीं है तो इसलिए जुडिशियल साइड से होने चाहिए
वो ये भी कह सकते हैं हमें जुडिशियरी पे ट्रस्ट नहीं है उनके कहने से क्या होगा
In any case, this is part of the law, which the law. Somebody could have challenged, and as pointed out earlier, earlier elections have taken place.
Yes.
So, is tarah, aur kab shuru hua hai, ye kab appoint hua, aur kitni training ho gayi abhi tak, what has happened so
far? About 11th of December ko ye appoint hua hai.
Aur abhi tak kitna?
Aur 3 din humne training, there were 7 days training, 3 days training took place, then we had to hold the training in compliance with the interim order.
So, ye batayen ke,
why you hold it?
Because the notification was suspended.
Notification suspended हुआ, training तो suspend नहीं हुई थी। अगर उनकी training हो जाती, तो क्या फर्क पड़ना था?
ये order कब pass किया इन्होंने?
ये कल pass किया। 13th ko parson.
And when was the election program due?
Aaj 15th ko.
Training
ek din hui hai sir.
Haan ji,
training sirf ek din hui aur 7 din ki training thi.
Idhar koi PTI ka koi hai? नहीं, हम उनसे समझना चाहते हैं ना भाई, वजह क्या थी ये करने की?
नहीं देखें, आप ये भी तो देखें, वो बंदा इंडिविजुअली कर रहा है, नाम वो यूज हो सकता है,
तारीख इंसर्टी
ऑफ एनी, कौन लोग हैं जो नहीं चाहते कि इलेक्शन हो?
यस,
ये बताइए, इसके बारे में बताएं, कौन लोग हैं जो इलेक्शन नहीं चाहते? इस तरह ओपनली कौन कह सकता है कि नहीं? और फिर हमारे ऑर्डर के खिलाफ जब हमने कह दिया कि इसको कोई नहीं डिरेल करेगा, तो कौन डिरेल कर रहा है?
We don't know, my lord. This is very strange kind of intervention, I would say. Contrary to law, the timing is very precarious.
But this constitution pe aap bata rahe the, whose responsibility it is to hold elections?
Election commission, my lord.
Which is their provision?
218 and
219, my lord. Toh phir judge saab hi election karwa le phir. आप तो क्या उनको कह दें वो इलेक्शन करवा लें? मतलब यू नो आई सॉरी, वी आर वेरी क्लियर. आपको याद है जब आपकी पिटीशन ये चल रही थी, हमने कहा आपका काम नहीं करेंगे,
नहीं करेंगे.
इट्स योर आपसे, मगर हम आपका काम करवाएंगे आपसे.
बिल्कुल,
बहुत फर्क होता है दोनों चीजें में.
बिल्कुल.
तो फिर मेरे ख्याल में आप अब ये सॉरी, दिस इज आई एम रियली सरप्राइज, ऐसे ऑर्डर्स पास हो रहे हैं जुडिशरी से. किधर है वो आपका कौन सा प्रोविजन है?
218 का 3 एंड 219 का डी. 218
in their petition before the High Court, what is the precise allegation against the 1000 people? Kya hai inko problem kya hai?
They generally attack at the executive jo hai free and fair election nahi karwayegi.
As a concept.
As a concept, not any individual.
No, but not at this stage when the election process has begun.
Has begun.
Sara, aapke paas time tha, aap law ko challenge karte, jo marzi karte.
More than 6 years, these two provisions had been on the statute book. And the timing is very precarious. Just
ये अटॉर्नी जनरल को सुना?
एडवोकेट जनरल को जी सुना. एडवोकेट जनरल को, अटॉर्नी जनरल ऑफिस को
भी. Were you called for
the additional attorney general?
No, yourself.
जी, notice was under 27A. Notice was issued, but the additional attorney general had appeared.
But you didn't appear.
I did not.
Why?
To be honest, I was not aware of this petition. I only came to know about the order when the order was passed in the evening, day before yesterday.
Late in the
That's a very serious passed. Statement you're making. The Attorney General of Pakistan was bypassed.
I was in the Supreme
Court. Hey, if the judge is there, he should first of all ask where is the Attorney General of Pakistan. I'm going to pass such a very strong order. Was he should have asked where is the Attorney General? Call him. Then they could have sought time or whatever. But the office in the constitution is not of the additional.
That's right.
There's a very straight, right, clear demarcation. That's there is no constitutional provision of additional advocate general.
That's
right. By the law.
That's by law.
The article 100 of the constitution says attorney general of Pakistan. Did he solicit advice from you? The additional. Sir, I've received this notice. What do you want me to do?
He did speak with me, and my instructions were to oppose the petition, and which is duly recorded in the order.
No, but आपने कहा आपको बाद में पता चला.
मुझे उस दिन सुबह उन्होंने मुझसे पूछा कि इसपे
क्या होना है.
When the order was passed, the morning.
नहीं, but ये notice तो पहले दी गई थी. पहले क्यों नहीं पूछा उन्होंने? Fix
होता. ये उस वक्त मैं उसका.
It was on a day-to-day fixation, my lord. 13th से पहले एक दिन पहले भी fix हुआ. 12 को हुआ, फिर 13 को हुआ. अगले दिन, very next day it was.
अच्छा, अगर ये कल बलूचिस्तान एक petition file हो जाती है, वो पंजाब के रोक देते हैं, सिंध वाले खैबर पख्तूनख्वा के रोक देते हैं.
जी.
It's very strange.
Jaswati, ये बताएं कि ये जो पीरियड है 7 days का ट्रेनिंग है.
7 days.
And then the program, election program kicks in on the 15th. आप जो होना था normal times में, जो
normal time में आज
program आना था.
And we were going to continue it in parallel to the issuance of the election
and
program.
When is the actual job of the DRO RO in the program that comes into
that, that's the last date for filing of the nomination. Lekin wo pehle din se shuru ho jati hai, because on
so
the very first
much
day,
has gone wrong in the sense that they can get back to some sort of training. And
hum 3-4 din piche chale gaye hain, but we are very tightly
training
fixed.
Training pe short ho gayi.
Ji.
Lekin I remember the last not the last elections when I was chief justice. We had conducted the court till 2:15 in the morning. So these matters on the 11th hour, a petition is filed. Not the 11th hour, beyond. And now you are in that danger zone where fallout will be delay of elections.
Absolutely,
ma'am. They were waiting and seeing, waiting and seeing till that point of no return comes, then file the petition. And doesn't the learned judge realize all these things? Has he assumed the responsibilities of the Election Commission of Pakistan? Would it constitute misconduct on the part of the judge?
In fact, it was.
If he's violating an order of the Supreme Court.
My lord. In fact, it was also highlighted.
Please assist us.
Ji.
My lord. Any Joe Marji, you wear a gown and then pass any order you want to.
You cannot. When they, under Article 189, the learned judge is bound by the.
He's not only passed an order in the territory of Punjab, he's passed an order for the whole of Pakistan.
Notification. All four, the set of notifications have been suspended.
Now, iska koi jawab diya tha wahan pe?
I think the best course of the judge was to say that the matter should, they should approach the Supreme Court in the light of the earlier order.
Especially
the notification is outside the territory of the Punjab.
Very, very true. Hello.
Attorney General, does it constitute misconduct?
My Lord, I have to go through the code of conduct, but if there was a Supreme Court order,
clear provision of the constitution, does he refer to our order?
No, it does not. And there was a Supreme Court order with.
No, he doesn't refer to the order.
It does not.
He doesn't refer to a constitutional provision.
No, my lord.
He passes an order beyond the territory of Punjab.
So appears, my lord. And my friend has just informed me that the learned additional attorney general, argued this
point. No, we may even issue contempt notice to the petitioner. I mean, he's a lawyer. He pretends to be a lawyer at least. How is he acting against the order? If he has a grievance, come to the Supreme Court. We've passed the order. He claims to be representing a political party. That political, on the basis of their petition, we had ordered elections.
That's right, my lord.
So what is this?
That's right.
So there are two things. One is that perhaps the best course would be that because there was a matter pending here, a direction had been given by the Supreme Court, the best course was for the High Court that take the matter to the Supreme Court.
Supreme Court. That's
one.
Right.
Number two, the notification is such that it covers all the provinces.
That's right.
So one High Court dealing with one province cannot deal with that. There is a judgment also which in a CSS matter, the idea was to go to the Supreme Court because you can't upset. I mean, you're actually upsetting the other provinces who don't want to.
The division bench judgment, my lord, was heading the division bench.
The CSS exam was challenged, and they said if one province will do it, it affects the entire exam for all the other provinces. So suppose people sitting in Balochistan and Sindh would like to go ahead, they are also affected. Sara dysfunctional log.
Sara, notifications have been suspended throughout.
Rani General, is he the same judge who had passed that order in the electricity petition? 1600 or 1100 petitions came before us?
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, this is not on. You have to stay within the confines of the constitution. We take oath to abide by the constitution, the law. And Article 189 is bound on him, on all courts. I mean, he's really upset our order. He's sort of disregarded our order. I mean, he doesn't even refer to it. He says suspended. His own Chief Justice saying that I can't spare judicial officers because I've got 13 lakh cases in the province. So there will be a writ issued against the Chief Justice.
No. Can't be.
Sorry, this is not on.
What's the possibility? Could you assist us? I mean, there was an earlier order. The entire election is being, there was a direction that 8th February ko hoga, and Supreme Court has passed orders that no step would be taken to derail.
Yes.
What is the possibility that if such a case has been filed, that is to be brought before the Supreme Court? Could that case be taken away from the High Court and brought here?
There are past precedents, my lord.
So that it is heard at one place for the entire country?
Yes.
Why should we give a relief to a person who is a contemner? I use the word contemner because he is derailing democracy.
That's right.
Why should this person hold Pakistan to ransom?
It's actually an individual.
It's an individual, my lord. That's what
I'm inclined to. I don't know. I'll tell, consult my colleagues to issue him contempt notice.
Once you get the petition here.
No, no. Why should I petition for contempt?
That's a good petition.
These things are happening.
Mr. Swati, there are 51-1 padhiye zara.
This is relating to the
Action Act. 51-1 mein phir ARO or RO of the judiciary.
51-1 jo hai wo deals with the
check karein, ye lawyer nahi hai, ye barrister Umair Khan Niazi.
He is an advocate, sir. He's an advocate of High Court, yes.
Yes, you know him?
Yes.
Which, is he a loan firm with some firm or what?
My lord, he had previously served as a law officer, as an additional advocate general in Punjab, but he was associated with Tehreek e Insaf. He was president of, as it is written in the memo of the petition also, he was he served as the president of the lawyers wing of that party.
He's not a young man then.
He's about as old as I am, so...
That's young now.
So a young man.
Somebody, he's not like in his 20s.
No.
That on his exuberance, he files a petition not realizing what he's doing.
My Lord, 51-1 provides for consultation with the Chief Justice for appointment of the judicial officers.
51-1.
The Commission shall, in the prescribed manner, appoint from amongst its own officers or officers of any government or corporations, comma, autonomous or semi-autonomous bodies controlled by any government or from the subordinate judiciary in consultation with the Chief Justice of the concerned High Court, a returning officer for each constituency. This is the provision which has been...
Agar 51-1 ko koi court ultra vires declare kar de, to kya kabhi election ho sakta hai?
Nahin. Then we have no other power.
50 ko chhod dete hain. 51-1 ko agar makammal ultra vires kar de, to ye election kabhi bhi nahi ho sakta. Fir derailing karna kehna, aap ye kehen ki election hi nahi karana chahte.
Election nahi karwana chahte.
To ye to inhe petition grant kar di, reh kya gaya phir isme?
This is the main relief granted at the interim stage, which is also unconstitutional, unlawful.
Achha, aapke paas koi darkhast nahi di, are you sure?
No, my lord, no, my lord. There was no, nothing of this sort ever agitated anywhere in the whole.
Dekhi, ho sakta hai, kahin galat ho gaya ho, kisi ka bhai wagaira ko appoint kar diya, is RO, chalein, ho sakta hai.
No, individual ka agar kisi ek ki kare,
wo kaya ji, aap ye banda guna hai, aur musse ko laga do, hum laga denge.
1500 banda hi biased hai inke against. Or inke against nahi, just against one individual. Probably he might be contesting from one constituency. आप उसके हद तक करें अगर आपको problem है. Come to us, we will look into.
और वो ये भी नहीं बता रहे कि उस officer में problem क्या है.
No.
They're saying कि as a concept executive नहीं.
As a concept, चूंकि हमारे against MPOs के orders की हैं deputy commissioners ने, तो इसलिए जो हमारे against partisan. This is the allegation.
ये बताएं कि RO और उनके खिलाफ कोई किसी को कोई biasness हो, तो आपके पास उनका आने का कोई है law?
जी.
कौन सी सेक्शन है कि उनको आपके पास आना चाहिए कि ना कि डायरेक्ट में जाना चाहिए? अगर रेमेडी आपके पास थी तो वहाँ आए नहीं आए? आपके पास
नहीं है? They've never approached us.
वो है कोई प्रोविजन बताओ?
It's 55 का 3 है.
Which?
Election Act का 55 का 3 जी. The commission 55-3. Section 55, subsection 3. The commission may at any time, for reasons to be recorded in writing, suspend or withdraw any election official, a public servant,
or,
55, section 55, subsection 3, my lord.
Yes.
The commission may at any time, for reasons.
So, article 199, zara padhiye, ayin ka. Ye to wahi mark kha jayega. Last time the same learned judge passed the same order. Kitna nuksan pahunchaya Pakistan ko?
Sir, I think the total was a few hundred billions. I don't remember the exact number, but few hundred billions actually. 500 billion or something.
Huh?
About 500 billion.
Then again, Nepra court ne bypass karke order kar diya.
Subject to the constitution, a high court may, if it is satisfied that no other adequate remedy is provided by law. Adequate remedy is there. Or in fact, ye assessment ke koi bias hai ya nahi hai, wo bhi kisi court ne nahi karna.
Ye khud ya to
wo election commission ne karna hai. Through their long arm of the people they work under election commission, because we have got people even at the lowest strata.
Long arm to law ki hoti hai apne.
Of the election commission pe wo bhi
thodi kam kar le
to short arm kar le.
आइए वायलेशन ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट
इट्स 204 मैन
नहीं वो तो आर्टिकल है ना
आर्टिकल 204 सेक्शन 3 ऑफ
ये तो जुडिशियल कंटेंप्ट हुआ ना
एंड सेक्शन 3 ऑफ द कंटेंप्ट
जरा पढ़ दें आप जरा दे दें इनको
मैंने प्रेस किया
हद हो गई
But you can get back onto the rails.
आपने शेड्यूल क्यों नहीं अपॉइंट अभी तक आपने शेड्यूल क्यों नहीं दिया है इलेक्शन
आज देना सिविल
नहीं आज आप देंगे
ट्रेनिंग के बाद
ट्रेनिंग के बाद हम
नहीं इलेक्शन शेड्यूल की बात कर रहा हूँ
शेड्यूल इलेक्शन प्रोग्राम जो है we had planned it after the training or
training can still continue on the
where
side
where is the schedule yes. show me the schedule
I don't have the schedule any
ट्रेनिंग तो आपने रोक दी
ट्रेनिंग कुछ और चीज है शेड्यूल
कह रहे हैं कि आप उसका शेड्यूल करेंगे इसमें कोई बात तो नहीं है
शेड्यूल किधर है आपका
शेड्यूल वी कैन ब्रिंग वी डिडंट ब्रिंग इट
हियर नो
वी वांटेड टू वी वर गोइंग टू इशू द शेड्यूल
टुडे
वी मस्ट बी रेडी समवेयर लाइंग समवेयर ना तो दिखा दें
हु इज द जेंटलमैन बिहाइंड यू
ही इज द सेक्रेटरी इलेक्शन कमीशन
जी तो
ये इट हैड ऑलरेडी बीन ड्राफ्टेड इट्स
ऑल तो यू विल इशू इट टुडे
नो नो लेट्स लेट देम ब्रिंग इट
Lordship, the idea was to issue the schedule right after the training, which has
why after the connection between the two.
That was what the commissioner decided that they will issue.
No, right but after Mr. Umar Amir,
there must be some connection,
and you must have drafted a program. To ban gaya hoga na?
Is the nomination paper denna? Is the ye karna?
Section 57 ke tahat, but you know,
where is that schedule?
That schedule is counted 54 days.
Where is the schedule?
We have it, sir.
We have the draft. We
no, no. When will you issue it?
It was supposed to be.
When will you
right
issue it?
Training,
right after the training.
When will you issue it?
Originally, sir, it was supposed to be.
When will
from
you
13
issue
to 16 the training?
When will
you wait, issue please. If you're
going, as your lordship,
if you if they are going to mock the law, is the election commission is going to mock the law? Show us the law which says schedule will be issued after training is completed.
But
refer to that provision.
No, it says no, simultaneously.
Yes. Show training, that provision.
Training can go on the side. That is just
training can go on till the election day. You can continue training
people. It says simultaneously with the
Where is the law which says training of officers?
So, Mr. Swati, you have not read this to the election commission earlier.
No, no.
This section 52 of
simultaneous. It says the simultaneous section 52.
It can go
parallel. 52 exceptional circumstances. Otherwise,
आप के लिए
आप जो कह रहे हैं शेड्यूल की लाजम है कि हम पहले ट्रेनिंग करेंगे ये कहाँ लिखा हुआ है ये कहीं भी नहीं लिखा हुआ तो बताइए
लॉर्ड
क्यों कह रहे हैं
60 डेज इन ऑर्डिनरी सर्कमस्टेंसेस बिफोर द इलेक्शन प्रोग्राम सिंस डीलिमिटेशन वाज
आज 8 फरवरी को अगर बैकवर्ड्स करें तो आज कितने दिन रह गए
आज टुडे इज द 55th डे
55th
डे 55वां दिन आज कल से 54th डे
आपको मिनिमम कितना चाहिए
54 डेज
तो यू हैव टू इशू द शेड्यूल
टुडे यू हैव टू इशू द शेड्यूल
टुडे
यस
टुडे
या तो फिर सबको बुला लीजिए फिर आप भी वायलेट कर रहे हैं अपना लॉ
नहीं सो वी वर गोइंग टू
आर यू मेकिंग अ डेफिनेट स्टेटमेंट यू आर इशूइंग इट टुडे और नॉट
अभी वी
हैव योर स्केड्यूल रेडी इशू इट
हे इफ यू आर सो कीन ऑन इलेक्शंस व्हाई आर यू बैकिंग ऑफ नाउ
वी आर नॉट बैकिंग
आई मीन ट्रेनिंग मिस्टर उमर हमीद आल्सो ट्रेनिंग इज जस्ट अ कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग व्हिच विल कंटिन्यू एक दिन की रात को एक्स्ट्रा करा दें
सर द आईडिया वाज इफ यू अलाउ मी सर द आईडिया वाज दैट वी विल कंप्लीट द ट्रेनिंग बिटवीन से 13 एंड 16 पे करेंगे
नाउ
व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज दैट वी गॉन अ लिटिल like 4 or 5 days ahead.
4 days.
So that was the idea of the commission, if you allow. The commission.
Had, आप एक मेरी बात सुनिए. आपको RO और DRO की जो actual ज़रूरत है इस program में schedule में तो भी आगे जाके ना कहीं.
नहीं, आगे
जाके नहीं. When is the first time they required to work?
क्योंकि nomination. The last date for nomination हमने schedule में देना है.
कब है?
अगर 57-2 का A देखें ना.
आप बताएं date बताइए ना. How many days do we have from today to that first assignment that DRO has to perform?
That's the sixth day from the issuance of the election program. ये 57-2 का A लिखा
हुआ है.
तो पहले दिन भी fifth day, first day पे, very first day पे भी nomination आके submit हो सकते हैं.
तो ठीक हो गया ना. अभी एक दो दिन की भी training होगी. आपने 4-5 दिन की और training करानी है, करा लें उसका तो कोई.
But
you can
training किसी ने रोकी नहीं है. देखें
that can be pushed.
बुलाओ जब आपने रोकी है, training को जारी रहने देते, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता था. ये तो खाली उसकी हद तक था. आपने पता नहीं क्यों रोक दिया. आप भी नहीं चाहते कि नहीं होना है इलेक्शन. बेसिकली इसको आप तो देखो, अगर आपने करने के लिए सीरियस किए हैं तो आप उसको कैरी ऑन करें.
असल में नोटिफिकेशन माय लॉर्ड वाज सस्पेंडेड, तो इस वजह से वो एज अ नेचुरल कॉन्सिक्वेंस.
नोटिफिकेशन सस्पेंड हुआ, आपने भी कोई नोटिफिकेशन जारी कर दिए.
Suspension of the notification of the appointments, which is ipso facto of what the.
आपने क्यों किया है? Why?
आपने क्यों किया?
Why you issued the notification for suspension of? आपने क्यों किया? आपको कहा था कोर्ट ने कि आप ये करें.
सर जब आर ओ जी सस्पेंड हो गए तो फिर नोटिफिकेशन.
आर ओ सस्पेंड हुए हैं, फर्ज करिए अभी हम उसको विड्रॉ कर लेते हैं. आपका तो नोटिफिकेशन रहेगा, वो इन फील्ड रहेगा ना.
इमीडिएटली वी विल सर.
व्हाई यू इमीडिएटली, व्हाई यू इशू इट?
तो इनका वो एक्सेप्ट. सो दैट वाज डन इन कंप्लायंस ऑफ द सस्पेंशन ऑर्डर.
भाई कंप्लायंस का, भाई कंप्लायंस
कोर्स किधर लिखा बिफोर दिस?
किधर लिखा हुआ है कंप्लायंस करें? किधर कहा है कि आप इशू करें? उन्होंने सस्पेंड कर दी, सस्पेंड हो गए, खत्म. तो व्हाई यू इशू? आपने क्यों इशू किया?
जब एक कोर्ट ने ऑर्डर ने सस्पेंड कर दिया तो आपको सिर्फ कहना है कोर्ट ने सस्पेंड किया है. मतलब आई थिंक यू जस्ट डिड एन एक्स्ट्रा थिंग इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड
कंफ्यूजन बिकॉज
कंफ्यूजन नहीं है, रिमूव नहीं होती. जैसे आपने रिमूव की, कंफ्यूजन तो थी, ऑर्डर लिखा हुआ है ठीक है.
We got the order.
There are notifications suspended by courts usually. Doesn't mean that FBR issues another notification saying now then all of my notifications suspended. ऐसा तो नहीं होता. I think this is just an extra
care में
totally unnecessary exercise जो आपने की.
मैं just respectfully submit whenever there is an order by any court.
Yes.
Then we whatever actions we have already allowed to go on, we revert, we hold those in abeyance, and when the court or the higher supreme judiciary gives us another order, then we restore it accordingly. That was all. Whenever there is simple, for instance, if there are limitation cases, because our own people are on the ground, they have to be given some orders by the commission also. That was the reason.
Okay. अच्छा, आपने स्टे भी मांगा है. स्टे एप्लीकेशन नंबर इज 10612 केस यू वांटेड. विल करेक्ट द ऑर्डर. आई एम प्रीटी एग्जॉस्टेड बाय नाउ.
My apologies, my lord.
No, it's good that you come. It's not your fault. This petition for leave to appeal assails the order of a learned single judge of the Lahore High Court, Lahore, dated
13th of December 2023.
Full stop. The impugned order
was passed on an on the petition, writ petition, filed under Article 199 of the Constitution of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, within bracket, Constitution, bracket close. Wherein the Election Commission of Pakistan, wherein the two petitioners before us and eight others were arrayed as respondents. All the petition sought the raid for it sought a declaration that sections 50 within bracket 1 bracket close within bracket small b and 51 within bracket 1 within bracket closed